Hi, everyone. It's me, Rhiannon. I'm back today. I'm in my car. I don't know if you can tell, but I thought I would do a drive with me video because I've never done one before. And I just thought it would be a fun thing to do. So I'm going to go to McDonald's and get a Coke, a Diet Coke, and then I'm going to go to Lidl. So I thought I'd just bring you along with me for a little chat. I will always remember both the lines on the day we were under the covers. Fast forward to 18, we are more than lovers. Yeah, we are all we need when we're holding each other. I'll tell you. It's all about you. It's all about you, baby. It's all about you. So I thought I'd just have a little chat when I'm driving, just about the things I've been up to, what I've been doing in my life. So I actually filmed a video today. I went with my friend Juliet to her uni and we went in the studio and we filmed like a really cool lookbook, which I was so happy with, and I edited it and put that up and it seems to be going down well, so I quite like that. And then what have I been doing? What have I been up to? I'm in third year of uni, so I'm just writing my dissertation all the time, really. So that's something that I'm doing. Oh, I sprained my ankle really quite bad. I went to Inflator Space, which is the UK's largest inflatable theme park, if you wanted to know. And I was there, I was bouncing, and my foot, bloody hell, does this van want to be any closer to me? And my foot went sideways into the bouncy castle, and I sprained my ankle. I was in so much pain, and I was like limping around. And this was like 15 minutes after we got there as well, and I've been literally wanting to go for months. So I literally carried on bouncing on my sprained ankle, and then I sat down after we finished and I was like, oh my God, this hurts so much. And I was like walking down the stairs and my friends had to help me like walk down the stairs because I couldn't actually physically walk. And then the girl who worked there like asked me if I was all right and took me in the first aid kit room, and I had to get wheelchaired out. It was really embarrassing. Oh, fucking right, you stupid. Are you joking? Beeping. What prick? Is he actually joking? Because it literally just turned green. What is his issue? I'm gonna look at him when he goes past. I hate people like that. Yeah, so I sprained my ankle at Inflator Space, I had to get wheelchaired out, and then for literally, like, it was hilarious on the night when I got in and I couldn't walk. Like, we had to get a delivery because I couldn't cook anything. It was fun. Jack was there, he was like help me like get dressed and whatever, because I literally had one leg, and I was like in the shower, I was sitting on a stool in the shower. It was quite like comical. And then the next day I got up to go to uni and I literally couldn't walk. I was like, shit. So then went to the hospital, and I had to have an x-ray, and nothing was broken, but I just really sprained my ankle. So yeah, there was a big bruise there for a few weeks, and then now it's fine. But apparently your ankle doesn't go back to normal after you sprained it, which is absolutely gutting, to be honest, because it's really fat.
Telling me there's no time. Losing you could be the end of me, and that I should do the things that I wanted to. How could I without you? Oh.
I used to love JLS. Aston was my favourite, Aston Marigold, the short one. I had the JLS hoodie, the blue Aston Marigold one, And I remember I used to work with leggings and Uggs. And I thought that, like, that outfit was just, like, top notch, but actually it wasn't. I also had a plain black top, which said JLS in pink sparkly writing. So yeah, I've come out the worst time. Silverlink roundabout is absolutely chocker. 25 past four, what a joke. People in the car next to us just looking at me, massive DSLR camera that I've got set up facing me. I'm in the wrong lane. That was really stressful. I was fully in the wrong lane. I wish there was a Costa drive through because I could have an iced coffee. I wonder if McDonald's do an iced coffee. Iced frappes. Do you do just a regular iced coffee or not?
Yeah, we do caramel or mocha.
Is it just like iced coffee?
It's a piece of either caramel or chocolate, which have a hint of coffee to it. The blended iced drinks.
Oh no, can I just have a Diet Coke, a large Diet Coke, please?
Yeah.
Thanks. Brilliant, thank you. He's trying to give us a frappe. Don't want a frappe. I just want an iced coffee. For God's sake. McDonald's Monopoly's on. Hiya. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thanks. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Can I drive? You know what I mean? Right, I'm gonna pull up in here. I'm literally parked on such a diagonal. Right. Let's look at my Monopoly. Shall we? Imagine I've won a car. So I've got Pall Mall £50 sports and fashion, need other ones, and I've got an instant win of a fruit bag or a McFlurry. Wonder which I'll get. Right, so now I'm gonna go to Lidl. My G Lidl. That makes sense. Can Lidl be my G? Probably not. I swear there wasn't a bump when I was driving in the direction of going in there. That is so strange. Oh, you know what? It's got such a fizz to it. It actually gets you, gives you instant indigestion, gives you instant, no, acid reflux. When it's got such a fizz to it, it gives you instant acid reflux. That's this bad boy. That man behind's talking to himself. But so am I. I can't wait, I need a hint. Baby, give me a hint. It's dangerous. So I've arrived at Lidl, I've had a bloody moment singing some High School Musical whatever, and now I'm just gonna go in and get my shopping. I hope you've enjoyed the drive with me. I've really enjoyed doing it. I feel like I've got a little friend here in the car, a little friend coming to McDonald's with me. McDonald's don't do iced coffees. I think that's what we've all learned from this. I'll see you next time. Bye!